Hello and welcome to Motors TV. The 2012 WR season is literally just hours from beginning, with a return to the legendary Monte Carlo Rally. Before that, we're proud to take you back for a final look at the best moments from 2011. Heading to the season finale in Wales, Rally GB, Sebastian Loeb had an 8-point lead from Mikko Hirvonen in the Drivers' Championship. But how did we arrive to this drama? Let's head back to where it all began and the Rally of Sweden. Sweden is the only snow round of the season, and we're riding on board with defending champion Sebastian Loeb. It's February the 11th, and this is the first stage of the year. The seven-time champion and trusty co-driver Daniel Elliner suffered from having to act as road sweepers on day one, where he sent the Citroën duo down the order. The first surprise of the year came in the form of Mads Østberg. The Stobart Ford driver completed the first group of stages in the lead. The Norwegian youngster led through special stage 10, but was finally dislodged from the top spot by Mikko Hirvonen in the factory Fiesta. Loeb was sixth overall, just behind teammate Sebastian Ogier. Rally Sweden will also be remembered for the first ever power stage, where it was Chris Patterson at the wheel of the number 11 DS3. Petter Solberg was forced to swap seats with his co-driver after losing his driver's permit for a speeding violation on a road sector. The WRC records books will show that Sebastian Ogier set the best time and took three bonus points, and not a single DS3 WRC finished on the podium, for Tiervenen scoring the first victory of 2011. After the snow came the desert and Rally Mexico, and the anticipated Loeb-Ogier rivalry was already very much on the boil. At the close of day two, Ogier led from Loeb, and we learned that Citroën employed team orders which didn't sit well with Loeb, and he attacked on the final sector of the morning. Ogier panicked and made a costly error in the final kilometers of the event. When he passed by his teammate, Loeb quickly realized how serious it was. The intra-team war had begun with the retirement of Ogier, and one couldn't help but wonder how intense the situation really was within the team. Loeb was happy to score his first win of the season, but he knew, perhaps, that damage had been done beyond repair.
Sebastian, this morning we were looking forward to a battle between yourself and Ogier. He's off the road, though. Disaster for Citroën.
Yeah, for sure I was not happy to see him there. Because it's not so nice to have to push between teammates and for the team and everything. But for me, it was my job to push. I'm fighting for my championship, so I had to push him.
The victory was Loeb's fifth in a row in Mexico, but there wasn't a celebratory feel in the Citroën camp. Rally Portugal was next, and during shakedown for round three of the season came the crash of the season. Ken Block's massive accident was seen around the world. Rally Portugal resulted in a war of tactics between Citroën and Ford, with Ogier coming out on top. The Frenchman put the disappointment of Mexico behind him and showed just how dominating he can be. A second place finish and three bonus points for best time on the power stage was good enough for Loeb to equal Hirvonen for the championship lead. The following round was held in Jordan, and Petter Solberg put in a massive performance to try to stay on pace with Ogier, Loeb and Latvala. But an accident for the 2003 world champion was representative of just how difficult a gear it would be for the Norwegian as he tried to run his own team.
Will it go?
Rally Jordan will always be remembered for its incredible finish. Due to logistical problems, the rally was shortened to just 2 days, but no one could have imagined how it played out. Heading into the power stage, Jani Matti Latvala led Ogier by a mere half second. It will come down to this final run held at the birthplace of Jesus Christ himself. Latvala did his level best, and now it was Ogier's turn. Frenchman came up with the goods, setting the best time on the power stage, taking 0.7 seconds from Latvala, and the win by just 0.2 seconds from the Finn, which is the closest margin of victory in an official round of the championship. Latvala was as upset as Ogier was pleased, but that didn't stand in the way of some accolades between the two drivers. Sebastian Ogier also made history in becoming the first driver to score 28 points from a single round, 25 for the victory and the 3 bonus points from the power stage. With his second consecutive win, he moved to the top of the championship table. Round 5, Rally Italia was held on the island of Sardinia. After barely losing out in Jordan, Latvala experienced more heartbreak when he crashed out on day 1. The big news from round 5 was the arrival of the factory minis to the World Championship. A limited program of 6 rounds, but still an important moment with the return of the iconic brand to rally competition. The two drivers, Danny Sordo and Chris Meek, wasted little time in demonstrating how serious they were and going after high points paying spots. The first go for the Mini in 2011 was a success, with the Spaniard taking a promising 6th place result. Among the misadventures of round 5 was Evgeny Novikov's accident. The young Russian is quick, sometimes too quick, and perhaps he doesn't listen enough to the notes coming from his co-driver.
You okay?
Yeah, I'm okay. You?
Yeah.
One driver who didn't put a wheel wrong was Sebastian Loeb. He went on to win the 2nd rally of the season and the 64th of his illustrious career. Hirvonen limited the damage in winning the power stage.
Et gauche, 150 mètres. Gauche ferme, 140 court frame pour 40 mètres. Droite, 130 long. 80 mètres. Droite sur frein pour 60 mètres. Droite 60, corde max. Et attention, gauche ferme 100.
Argentina was next on the calendar, and something happened that would have championship implications. Rally leader Sebastian Ogier rolled. The crash took place on Special Stage 17 and was a crushing blow to the young Frenchman's battle. With equal equipment with his veteran teammate, that is to say, with the same car.
Sebastian, obviously, that problem in the previous stage, how did it affect you in this one?
I have no power steering, but I do what I can. I try to fix the car as hard as I can, and now it's not so bad. It should be okay to go until the end. That's the most important now.
He couldn't possibly have offered Loeb anything better to go on to win this rally, which he has won the past 6 years. Greece was round 7 of the year. Yari Matti Latvala is on the attack. But sadly, the Latvala experienced problems with the gearbox and front differential on his Fiesta RS WRC. Latvala was going through a tough patch with 3 consecutive rounds with just a few points to add to his total. This pretty much brought his title hopes to an end, which explains why later in the year the team decided he would work to help teammate Mikko Hirvonen. Ogier held on and held off Loeb, who wasn't about to give up. Ogier went on to win Rally Greece and the power stage to add 28 more points to his tally. Here's how they stood at the mid-season. As we can see, it was as tight as ever and anything was still possible. WRC caravan headed to Finland for the most prestigious rally of the year. Rally Finland is a true test of skill and courage, where it's very easy for things to go terribly wrong, as we'll show you, with some spectacular accidents from the same corner. A catastrophe for Hirvonen. 1 year after his terrible accident, he fell victim to brake and suspension woes. The battle was tremendous between the two Sebs, but a slow leak on the final day marked Ogier's demise. Loeb went on for the win, beating the Northern Europeans on their own turf. It was Loeb's most impressive win of the year and his 66th overall. The Frenchman now the only non-Scandinavian to win Rally Finland twice. We now come to Germany, where Loeb has never lost in 8 years. A win through the vineyards and military installations of Germany for the Frenchman is the safest bet in motor racing. And yet, a puncture on day 2 caused Loeb to lose more than a minute. The following morning, it was announced that Loeb had agreed to a 2-year extension at Citroën, where he would be the unquestioned number one driver. Ogier was not pleased and let the world know how he felt let down by his team. Following this mishap for Loeb, Ogier set the paddock abuzz with an inflammatory remark.
I don't know. I think maybe in a straight I saw it was a few rocks on the road. I think it's coming from that because I was taking it easy, but what can we do?
What's going to happen now? I mean, there was team orders this morning, but that's not Ogier's fault.
No, that's not Ogier's fault, so I don't know. That's it.
Sebastian, I don't know whether you want to celebrate or not, but you've just been handed the lead with a mistake there for the puncture of Loeb.
For sure, I don't want to celebrate it.